Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. So today I'll be continuing with the fifth video of the playlist where we are making a gym website. So in my previous videos I have showed you starting from how to install Xampp, then how to install WordPress, Astro Theme, Elementor, and then we have developed our homepage, about me, classes, publication, get fit, all of that I have showed you on the previous videos. So if you are completely new to this video, then I highly recommend you to watch the entire playlist and then you can start watching this video. Alright, so in this video I'm going to show you how to change the menu over here, then how to change the logo, and then I'm also going to show you how this site will look on your phone. Alright, so do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee you if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things, and if you still face any issues in the middle, please do comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to change this publication with content creator. Remember, I have told you about that on my previous video. So we have made that as content creator instead of publication. So we have added a YouTube channel link here. So subscribe button will redirect to your YouTube channel link. Currently I have set my channel. So you are going to change the menu over here. Instead of publication, it's going to be content creator. So for that you need to go to your pages tab. So remember, from this pages tab we are invoking each of the pages, right? So from here we can see that we have a publication over here, right? So this is what we need to edit. So to click on this quick edit, and it will show you this quick edit. So here you can change the title. So I'm going to change the title with content creator, and I'm also going to change the slug over here with the same content dash creator, right? So slug basically means, you can see like here it is after WordPress, it is showing something like get dash fit, right? So similar to this, if you switch over to the publication, you can see it is showing publication, right? So instead of publication, it will show content creator, whatever you are giving over here. So that is what it's going to show up here. So let's first click on update, and you can see that it is properly updated now. So now if you go to your publication and if you just simply refresh this, you can see that this page does not exist now, but you can see that our menu is rightly changed over here. So if you click on this content creator, it's going to show you that same page, but this time our menu is changed with content creator. You can see the URL is also changed with content creator, and all the details on this page are related to that content that you are creating on your YouTube, right? So that watch video, then subscribe, all that it is showing. So in this way you can change the menu. If you want to change the text of this menu for class, then get fit and all, so similarly you can do that on this page section. So you need to click on quick edit and you can modify that, right? Next thing that I'm going to talk about is how to change the logo. So for that you need to click on customize, then our Astro customize option is rightly open. So let's first switch to our home page. So this is our home page and we are in customizable mode. So first thing that you need to do is you need to click on this icon, that logo, that icon beside the logo, and immediately you'll be seeing this first one is logo, then we have a retina logo. So both thing is what we need to update, right? So how to create a logo, right? That is the first thing that I'm going to show you. So let's close all this tab, and in Google I'll just simply search gym center logo png. All right and you can go to this images tab, and you need to click on tool and uses rights. You need to change to creative common license, and you can see we are having lot of logo which are under creative common license, so you can use that. So maybe I'm selecting this one. I'm going to just open this image in a new tab, and I'm going to download this image and going to save that locally on our system. So you can see it is slightly saved. So let's open the folder. So this is our image. So I'll open this in paint, and I'm going to click on the selection tool, and I'm going to just simply nudge that a bit above. right? And then I'm going to, you know, choose this text icon, and I'm going to put here muscle maker as a text, right? And then I'm going to select this text, and I'm going to change the font to something like, maybe, you know, Broadway, let's say, right? So I'll increase the font, and I'm going to put it right in center, right? And I'm going to change this, you know, page size to a bit shorter. So you can see it is properly set now. Now I'll go to this resize, and I'm going to put this horizontal to something like maybe 20%, right? So same for vertical, click on OK. So you can see now it is, you know, properly a logo size. So I'll go to file and save this, you know, as a PNG format. So within desktop, I'm going to save this, probably naming it like muscle maker. I click on save, and then I'll go back to my site. So here is our site. So first I'll remove this image, I'll remove the Retina logo as well, and I'm going to select logo, and this time I'm going to browse it from my desktop. So if I go to desktop, you can see we have this logo that we have created. So I'll just simply click on that. So it's going to import over here, and then I'm going to select, and I'll skip cropping, and there you go. You can see logo is rightly added over here as well as on our header, right? So similarly, you need to put that logo onto our Retina logo as well. So select image. So under media library, you'll be seeing that same image. So I'll choose that image, and it's going to set for our Retina logo as well, right? So now if you just simply click on publish, and if you just simply, you know, probably refresh your site, you can see that our logo is properly updated, muscle maker, right? So this way you can update your logo, then you can update your menu, you know, all of that. Now I'm going to show you how our site will look on our phone. So if you, you know, switch to our customize tab, and you can, you know, select, you can see we have these three options, right? So if you select the middle one, that is basically tab. So this is how it's going to look on any tab. So you can see first we have the logo, then we have a hamburger icon, where if you click on that, you can see all the menus over here, right? I'll close the menu. So I'll scroll down, you can see, you know, all the features that we are going to provide. Then it comes the number speak, and then it also shows that image, then benefits of gym, and finally the testimonial part is also here, and finally that join hundreds of healthy people, right? And we have the footer here as well. So if you need to change the footer, you can always click on this icon, and you can change your, you know, copyright, then you can change the current year or title. So this will always take the current year, whatever is there on the server. So that server time is going to take, and site title will be whatever title you are giving, right? So you can see here also we have a title called muscle maker. So that's, so that same thing going to apply over here, powered by muscle maker, right? So that also, if you want to change, you can change that by just simply clicking on this pencil icon, and you can change it over here. All right, so I'm going to recommend not to change anything here, but if you still want, you can do that, right? So that's how it will look on any tab. So if we switch to phone, you can see that is how it's going to look on our phone. So first we again have logo, then we have a hamburger icon, so which will show all the menus. So this hamburger icon, you can see that it is blue color, so we need to change it to something black. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this pencil icon, and then, you know, I'm going to go over to the design, and you can see icon color is currently set to blue. So I change that to black, and I'm going to also change the border. So you can see border color is over here, so I'll change it to black also. So you can see now it is properly black. So if you click on that, you can see all the menu, right? And I'm also going to show you, if you let's say don't like this icon, you like probably this one. So you can see now that icon is changed. You can also click on this one, the third icon type, so that will show you this triple dot. So that also you can do, right? It totally depends upon your choice. So I'll choose the first one and I'm going to click on publish, and immediately whatever we have saved, so that's going to be published on our site. So yeah, so that's how it looks on our phone. So you can see we have, you know, everything properly, you know, responsive. So that's how it's going to look on our phone. You can always change it to different menu, probably if you want to go to content creator. So you can easily go there by just simply clicking on the menu over here, and you can see we are in content creator page. So everything is responsive, right? Yeah, so that's how you change the hamburger icon, and that's how it look on our phone, right? So I'll switch back to the desktop mode, and here if you see that we have first logo, so that is shown over here, like site title and logo. Then we have a gap right in middle, so that gap is, you can see over here, and then we have primary menu, so that is lying over here. So if you want to add something in middle, you need to click on this plus and you can add something in middle. So I'm just showing a demo, like you can add some social media. So if you click on that, it's going to show up over here, right? But it does not look good, so I just wanted to show you, right? So if you want, you can do that. Maybe if you are having some offer running only for that particular day, you can, you know, put something like here, and you can put some, you know, offer for that particular day. So that's also you can do. All right, so you know, let's go back to our home page. Here you can see that everything is properly set. So you can see number speak, then benefits of gym, and all of that is properly set now. So you're good to go. So you can now migrate this site to a hosting platform, and we can let our this muscle maker site available globally. So anybody will be able to see your site from any part of the world, right? So that is what we are going to do on my next video. So you are going to migrate this site, entire site, onto a platform called Cloudways. So I am going to use this Cloudways platform to deploy our site in my next video. So you'll also need to buy one domain. So like here we have developed Muscle Maker. So something like musclemaker.com or musclemaker.tech or musclemaker.online, something like that. We need to buy one domain. So I just simply open again a new tab, and if you just simply type something like, you know, GoDaddy, hit enter, you can see that GoDaddy domain name. So from here you can, you know, search your domain like Muscle Maker, hit enter, and immediately you can see that it is started to find one domain, and you can see that our Muscle Maker domain is available. So if you scroll down, you can see that you can buy some cheap domain like musclemaker.shop or musclemaker.xyz, you know, something like that you can buy. You can also buy the musclemaker.com, but this is, someone is already purchased, so you can use something like themusclemaker.com instead. So that is available, right? So you can see from here you can buy any of the domain, or you can also use Hostinger. So just simply type Hostinger over here, and from here also you can get a free domain. So click on this get a free domain, and you can search the same Muscle Maker and hit enter. You can see it is rightly started finding all the domains. So you can see musclemaker.shop is absolutely free, then musclemaker.tech is free, but these are like free for the first year, and I know for the next year onwards you need to pay this much amount. All right, so you can, you know, buy any of the domain, and you can, you know, point that domain onto our Cloudways where we are going to deploy. So all of that I am going to show you on my next video. So you need to buy one domain either from GoDaddy or Hostinger, or there are other platform as well like Namecheap and all. You can always, you know, use other platform as well. So to buy the domain, and once you have the domain, so in my next video I'm going to show you how you can, you know, migrate that entire website that you have developed onto Cloudways, and then how to point that domain. Everything in detail I'm going to show you on my next video. All right. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.